Hi everyone, hope all are keeping well. Through this video, I am going to explain to you the second poem from the book First Flight from Standard 10. The poem Fire and Ice has been written by Robert Frost, and the video that I have created is actually a bit different from other conventional videos, and it has been done on purpose so that it will be easier for you to understand and comprehend. The video has been made with the help of a certain slideshow. I hope you like it. So without wasting any time, let's begin. Fire and Ice is the second poem from the book First Flight, Class 10. It has been written by Robert Lee Frost, born on 26th March 1874. He belongs to the 20th century. Robert Lee Frost is different from other modern poets because he was modern in his spirit and traditional in the style of his poetry. It is a short poem consisting of two stanzas. These two stanzas deal with two different possibilities about the destruction of the world. How the poet has used the two elements, that is, fire and ice, both literally and symbolically, is worth appreciating. The title of the poem is short and crisp, but meaningful. It contains in itself the whole gist of the poem. Fire and ice are used symbolically for two temporary sets of emotions. Robert Frost shows the prevalence of fiery passions like fury, cruelty, violence, and greed, as well as of the cold feelings like hatred, indifference, and insensitivity. Now, let me explain you the first stanza. The first stanza goes like this. Some say the world will end in fire, some say in ice. From what I have tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor fire. The poet Robert Frost states that there are two schools of thoughts, holding contrary opinions about how the world will meet its end. Some people are of the view that it would end because of intense heat, as there is increasing global warming. In other words, the deep heat of fire deep in the earth, like the natural calamities like volcano, earthquakes, tsunamis, which will one day end the world. The sun may emit scorching rays and the world may burn down, but there are others who believe that the sun may lose its heat, leading the earth frozen to end. However, in his own experience, the poet subscribes to the opinion of those who think that the world would end in fire. Here, fire and ice are not only used literally, but they also have a symbolic meaning. Fire stands for fierce, fiery, violent passions, whereas ice, on the other hand, is symbolic of cold feelings. Now let me throw light on the literary devices used by the poet in this stanza. The first one is alliteration. It is the occurrence of the same sound at the beginning of adjacent or closely connected words. The first example you can see in the first line, that is, some say the world will end in fire. You can see that the letter S and W have been repeated. Then look at the other line, I hold with those who favor fire. Here the sound of F makes the expression musical. Then let's go to anaphora. Anaphora is a poetic device. It is a word or a group of words that is used repeatedly at the beginning of sentences or clauses to create a special effect or to emphasize on something. So you can see over here, like, some say the world will end in fire, and then again some say in ice. The phrase some say has been repeated to lay emphasis. The poet has also used symbolism. Symbolism is the use of symbols to signify ideas and qualities by giving them symbolic meaning that are different from their literal sense. For example, fire. Fire is used as a symbol for anger, lust, greed, violence, And ice is symbolic of hatred, indifference, apathy, and lack of concern for others. The poet has used enchantment. It is an idea that doesn't end with a line, but is carried on to the next line without any punctuation, like comma or full stop. So you can see here that the first line continues into the second, and similarly, the third line is continuing to the last line. So this is an example of enjambment. Now let's discuss the rhyme scheme of the poem. The poem consists of 9 lines, 2 stanzas. There are 4 lines in the first stanza, and the rhyming scheme will be AB, AA. The second stanza is of 5 lines, and it goes like this. But if it had to perish twice, I think I know enough of hate to say that for destruction ice is also great and would suffice. So in this stanza, the poet continues his idea that the earth would perish, but the force of destruction is completely in contrast to the force in the first stanza. In the first stanza, we saw that the poet was supporting the people who favor fire. He thinks that people have lost all the emotions that are considered to be warm. They have lost affection, love, kindness, consideration, and even sympathy. These emotions have been replaced by the cold emotions of hatred and jealousy. So, the feeling of hatred and jealousy is so intense that the poet feels that it can potentially lead to the destruction of the world. The end of the poem suggests that it doesn't matter whether the fire is stronger or ice, both carry strong elements which may finally annihilate the world. Now, let us throw light on the literary devices in the second stanza. The first literary device is enchantment, because you can see that the thought of the second line continues to the third, then to the fourth, and finally to the fifth without the use of any punctuation. Then the poet has undoubtedly used a beautiful rhyme scheme over here. As you can see, there are 5 lines in the stanza, so the rhyme scheme will be AB, AB, A. Then we have assonance. Assonance is the close repetition of the same vowel sounds within a group of words and not letters. Remember, dear students, within a group of words and not letters. So now we come to an end of the explanation. I hope all of you understood what the poem is about. Okay, dear students, that's all for now. Thank you and see you again.